Hey, mathematicians, it's Justin again. I'm back home from my trip to Miami, and I'm unpacking the souvenirs I got for my friends. I got a hat, keychains, a cafecito set with mugs, and so much more. Check it out. Oh, this bundle of gifts weighs a ton. Actually, that's an exaggeration. A ton is a unit we use to measure really, really heavy things. These gifts don't weigh a ton, but they do feel pretty heavy. I need to figure out how much everything actually weighs because I'm gonna mail them out. I've got a scale, but I'm not sure about the units. Hey, let's sort this out together. And along the way, we'll learn all about the units we use to measure how heavy things are. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to name the customary units of weight, like ounces, pounds, and tons. You'll also know how to convert between them using multiplication and division. Have your guided notes ready, and let's explore how we measure weight. First, we should talk about what weight means. Weight is the measure of how heavy something is. We use different units to measure weight depending on how heavy or light the object is. A slice of bread weighs about 1 ounce. Ounces are a measure of weight, but don't confuse them with fluid ounces, which measure volume. Even though they share the word ounce, they're two completely different measurements. Today we're focusing on ounces as the smallest unit of weight. If 1 ounce is about the weight of a slice of bread, what else might weigh an ounce? A pencil weighs about 1 ounce, and a small bag of chips weighs just a few ounces too. Our next unit of weight is pounds. There are 16 ounces in 1 pound. So if a slice of bread weighs about 1 ounce, 16 slices, or a whole loaf, would weigh 1 pound. We often use pounds to describe the weight of everyday objects. A soccer ball, for example, weighs about 1 pound. We can use pounds to describe the weight of heavier things too, like a big dog. That could weigh 60 pounds or more. And a ton? That's huge. 2,000 pounds. Think about a car or an elephant. That's what we measure in tons. So when I said my gifts weighed a ton, I was just exaggerating. They don't actually weigh 2,000 pounds. A ton is way more than anyone could carry in their suitcase. People usually use abbreviations for these units of measurement instead of writing out the whole name. Ounces are abbreviated as OZ, and pounds are abbreviated as LB. Tons are abbreviated with just a capital T. These abbreviations save space and make it quicker to write down weights. So, now you know. 16 ounces equal 1 pound, 2,000 pounds equal 1 ton, and we use abbreviations to write all of these. Okay, to weigh my souvenirs, which unit of measurement should I use for the lighter objects, like the hats and keychains? Ounces, yeah. And what about the heavier gift? Do you think I'll need to measure this in tons? No, I was able to carry all these souvenirs in my suitcase, so pounds should be the right unit for the heavier item. I need to figure out if my souvenirs are going to be affordable to mail. The post office charges a lower rate for packages under 2 pounds, but anything over 2 pounds costs more. The hat weighs 4 ounces, and the shipping box adds another 6 ounces, for a total of 10 ounces. How many ounces are in a pound? 16 ounces, right. So is this package going to ship at the lower rate? Yeah, 10 ounces is less than 1 pound, so it's definitely less than 2 pounds. Now let's check out the heaviest souvenir, this coffee set, which weighs 34 ounces. Pause here to figure out if this is less than 2 pounds. 16 ounces equals 1 pound, so 32 ounces equals 2 pounds. That means 34 ounces is more than 2 pounds, and that's without the box. Looks like this package will cost more to mail. Knowing the weight of something is definitely useful here, but it's not just about mailing packages. Why else do we measure weight in everyday life? Take a moment to jot down your own ideas in your notes. When have you needed to know how much something weighs? You might have said that knowing something's weight can be important in figuring out how much an item might cost, how much of something we should buy, and whether you're able to pick up and carry certain objects. One place where this is particularly helpful is in the grocery store. For example, fruits and vegetables are often priced by weight. Why don't we head over there and check out weights in action? Oh, hey, not at the store yet, sorry, but I'm taking the bus and we just passed by a sign by the bridge that said there was a 67,000 pound weight limit. This city bus weighs 14 tons. Since 1 ton is equal to 2,000 pounds, how many pounds is 14 tons equal to? Think about what we've learned about converting units from previous lessons to support your thinking. Pause here to figure it out in your guided notes. As we've practiced before with length and volume, to go from a bigger unit to a smaller unit, we multiply. So to convert from tons to pounds, we multiply by 2,000 because there are 2,000 pounds in a ton. Therefore, 14 tons times 2,000 equals 28,000 pounds. That's one heavy bus. All right, let's check out some items from my shopping list and practice a few weight conversions. First up, a bag of flour. It weighs 5 pounds. How many ounces is that? Pause here to solve in your guided notes. Since there are 16 ounces in 1 pound, to convert pounds to ounces, we multiply by 16. So 5 pounds times 16 equals 80 ounces. That's 80 ounces of flour. Next, rolls of paper towels. They weigh 2 pounds, 8 ounces. When we have a measurement that uses two different units like this, we call it a mixed unit. So, how many ounces is this in total? Pause here to solve. Let's break this down step by step. First, convert the pounds to ounces. Since 1 pound equals 16 ounces, multiply 2 by 16, and that gives us 32 ounces. What do we do next to get the total ounces since the paper towels weigh more than just 2 pounds? That's right, we add the extra 8 ounces. 32 plus 8 equals 40 ounces. So the rolls of paper towels weigh 40 ounces. Now try going the other way, converting ounces to a mixed unit with pounds and ounces. This jar of tomato sauce weighs 28 ounces. How many pounds is that? You may have ounces left over. As we've practiced before, to go from a smaller unit to a bigger unit, we divide. Pause here to figure it out in your guided notes. To convert ounces to pounds, divide by 16. 28 divided by 16 equals 1 pound with a remainder of 12 ounces. So 28 ounces is equal to 1 pound and 12 ounces. Generally, anything over 16 ounces is converted to pounds or displayed with pounds and ounces, as we've just practiced with our tomato sauce. Moving on to this bag of apples, it weighs 96 ounces. How many pounds is that? To go from ounces to pounds, we divide by 16. We haven't done a lot of dividing by two-digit divisors, so another way you could figure this out is by using the multiples of 16. Since 1 pound equals 16 ounces, you can follow the pattern. 1 pound is 16 ounces, 2 pounds is 32 ounces, 3 pounds is 48 ounces, and so on until you reach 96. Pause here to solve 96 divided by 16 in your guided notes, using whichever strategy works best for you. The bag of apples weighs 6 pounds. And to check, 16 times 6 equals 96. Nice work. These conversions are super handy for grocery shopping or anytime you need to understand weight in different units. So, what have we learned today, besides the fact that knowing how much something weighs can be pretty useful? Well, now you know that ounces, pounds, and tons are all units we use to measure weight. You've practiced converting smaller units to bigger units using division, and from bigger units to smaller units using multiplication. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to practice working with multiplication and division to convert between units of weights. And remember, mathematicians, in math, as in life, every effort adds to your success. I'll see you next time.